Welcome everyone to a new episode from Transylvanian Food. In today's video I would like to show you how to do a meat feast. How I told you in the previous video, today we're gonna make a very typical and traditional dish. It's called Pomana Porcului, translated it's pork's alms. It's a dish full of meat, it's basically 90% meat. We're gonna serve it with mashed potato and with sauerkraut. Or you can use any kind of pickle you like or you prefer. Let's go through the ingredients and we're gonna start to cook. How I said earlier, this dish is full of meat. We got 1 kilo of pork shoulder. I got here 150 grams of smoked sausage. These are homemade, but you can use any smoked sausage you prefer. I got also 200 grams of the pork fat. I got 4 slices of smoked lard, 12 cloves of garlic, 5-6 potato for a mashed potato for the garnish, some fresh parsley and spring garlic. These are all the ingredients for this dish, plus salt and pepper, and I'm gonna use 1 ladle of stock before we finish the dish. Prep wise, I will start with the potatoes. I'm gonna make only 2 portions of mashed potato. This pot should be enough. You need to make sure when you do mashed potato that the potato, they are similar sizes. Otherwise they're not gonna cook in the same time and you're gonna have small pieces which they're not gonna be cooked. Always when I do mashed potato, I always put 2 small cloves of garlic to add more flavor. And plenty of salt. Now I'm gonna put water and I'm gonna put it to boil. Now we're gonna start with the meat. I got here, how I said, 1 kilo of the pork shoulder. You can use any cut from the pork, you can use. Normally it's used for this dish, the tenderloin and a piece of pork shoulder. But I prefer honestly the pork shoulder because it's got more fat. And you know, more fat is more flavor. I'm just gonna cut it in cubes. This is the size. This is basically all the prep. What I'm gonna need to do later is to chop the parsley and the spring garlic. I got here a 4-liter pot. I'm gonna start putting the pork fat with the smoked sausages in. I know you're gonna say it's a lot of fat, but trust me, you're not eating the fat, you're eating the meat. You just mix it to melt nicely. Now I'm gonna take out the sausages because they are already cooked. I just wanted to melt the fat from them. The fat is hot, so we're gonna go with the meat in. I'm not gonna put any salt or pepper or nothing until it's not sealed the meat proper. Now we're gonna leave it to seal nicely on each side. As you can see, I got here the mashed potato. It's almost boiling. The meat is sealed, so I'm gonna put some Maldon salt on. Not too much salt. I'm gonna put some cracked black pepper. And I'm gonna put back the sausages. Now I'm gonna put a ladle on and I'm gonna leave it to boil like that until it's cooked 99% of it. Now the meat, as you can see, it's halfway cooked. I got here a pot with chicken stock which I done earlier. I'm gonna put 1.5 ladle of the chicken stock on and I'm gonna leave it for another 20 minutes to cook. How you can see, I got here the potato for the mashed potato, they are cooked. One thing which I forgot to mention is the butter for the mashed potato. I'm gonna use 150 grams of butter for 1/2 kilo of potato. I'm not gonna put any cream, any milk, I'm gonna use only salted butter. Now I'm gonna drain the potato and I'm gonna show you how I do the mashed potato. Extremely important when you do mashed potato is to put the butter when the potatoes are very very hot. If you do the mashed potato where after the potato is cooling down, it's gonna be very gooey, it's gonna be a lot like glue. And we definitely don't want that. And now I'm gonna just crush it nicely. Now you can see the butter is melting nicely. And this is how I get always a lovely, creamy and smooth mashed potato. After 40 minutes, I will show you the meat is cooked. See, it's falling apart. I'm not gonna leave it more. What I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna put the garlic in. I'm just gonna crush it in. Also, I'm gonna put the spring garlic, the green one. And I'm gonna give a good mix. I will leave it 1 minute and I'm gonna take it off the stove. After 1 minute, the food is ready. The smell, it's amazing. Now I'm gonna put it on the side and I'm gonna do the final touch. I got here a pan, gonna leave it to get hot and we're gonna cook the smoked lard. The pan is hot, so I'm gonna put the smoked lard in. We used to call this Transylvanian octopus and you're gonna see why in a minute. We leave it 2 minutes on each side and after we take it out and we're gonna start with the plating. It's extremely important when you cook the smoked lard to cook it on low heat. This is how it looks after 2 minutes. And because of this shape, that's why we call it Transylvanian octopus. We leave it another 2 minutes and we're gonna do the plating. The plating, we're gonna keep it very simple. I put here some cling film on a spoon. And I'm gonna take one big spoon of mashed potato. Put it in the middle. Now we're gonna put the meat. Gonna put one sausage as well. And the fried smoked lard. Some fresh parsley and we can serve. This is my dish for today. It finally came the my favorite moment, the taste testing. I'll show you one more time the plate, the dish. We're gonna take a little bit of the mashed potato with one piece of the meat. For my taste, it's the perfect traditional dish. If you like this video, please give us a like, a share, and also don't forget to subscribe to the channel. And I will see you next week with a new Transylvanian recipe. Thanks for watching us. Thank you.